J-Ray501 here. I'm in Medical Express. Neuroethicist argues for continuing research into memory-dampening drugs. Unafraid to stir up a hornet's nest of controversy, Adam Kolber, a Brooklyn Law School professor, has published an essay on Nature, declaring that he believes it's time the debate over whether to continue research into pharmaceuticals that can alter, dampen, or erase memories should end. He says that it's clear, at least to him, that the benefits of such drugs would far outweigh the negatives, and that research should move full speed ahead so that those who suffer the negative effects of bad memories can get on with their lives in ways they would have had the bad thing they remember never occurred. Others are not so quick to agree. Some suggest that such drugs could alter a person's personality, denying them the life they would have lived had they not taken the drug. Others suggest that such drugs could be used for illicit purposes, such as being dispensed to people who have witnessed a crime. Kolber rebukes such fears, declaring that there are already laws on the books in most countries, disallowing the use of drugs for such purposes. Though this argument may be weak here, in the instance where criminals are dispensing such drugs, it's doubtful they'd concern themselves much about the legality, much less the ethics of forcing a witness to their nefarious activities to take a pill to forget what they've seen. Some might even call this an improvement on the status quo, as the alternative now is for the bad guys to simply kill those that have seen what has gone on. As for such drugs altering the makeup of a person or changing their personality, Kolber argues that if a drug were developed that could target and remove a single memory, such as a traumatic event, giving a person that drug would actually allow them to live the life they would have led otherwise, thus allowing them to retain the personality they were meant to have, but were denied due to a horrible experience. The issue of whether to press on with such research has become more of a practicality in recent years, as enough progress has been made in the lab to suggest that memory-erasing drugs could soon become a reality. We already have such drugs as Propranolol, which can block memory-strengthening brain chemicals, and has even been used in at least one such circumstance, that of a cancer patient who overheard her diagnosis accidentally and was given the drug by an anesthesiologist to remove the memory and thus the trauma of what she'd heard. Kolber also notes in his essay that it seems a bit premature to decree the use of memory-dampening drugs in light of the obvious positive impact such drugs could have for people suffering from post-traumatic stress syndrome after returning from war, or less dramatically, from nightmares after an assault. He does point out that such drugs would, of course, be given by prescription only, and thus could be regulated like any other drug, making them just as safe as drugs they are used to relieve physical pain. Wow, that is really scary. Can you imagine? I mean, they've already used it. So can you imagine all the guys returning from war? All of our patriots returning from war and being given a bunch of drugs like this so that they wouldn't have to recall or deal with post-traumatic stress syndrome or whatever. Just erase all that negativity, and then they could put them right back out on the front line. Oh, boy. Well, my theory on this is that it might already be happening. Look at all of the push for psychotropics, so that we get a quick fix and we don't have to deal with serious issues that are traumatizing to us. We just take a pill every day and it deadens you out and dumbs you down. So this is going to take it one step further and just remove those memories from your brain? What about them, and how do they know how to target that area of the brain where that particular memory is? So if they can delete in our supercomputer brain, if they can go in and delete negative memories, then of course they can go in and delete pleasurable memories or happiness and keep us more in a state of fear and being able to be controlled. Fear will keep us in a state of looking for the government, you know, looking for help, looking to be taken care of, because when you're paralyzed with fear, you can't do anything. You become stuck. So one step further in fear makes you dangerous, because then you're not controllable, and then you do become out of control. Whoo! They're really ramping up on the control stuff. I just wanted to put this out here. Oh, stay safe. Be alert. God bless.